everybody, welcome back to my YouTube channel. Today I'm going to be filming a very, very exciting video, as you can tell by the title. So I'm going to be filming, trying the whole of the M&S bakery. Now I wanted to do like just anywhere bakery. And I know that M&S has really nice like pastries, but I've never tried their like donuts and stuff, so I did want to go there. I was gonna go to Lidl because I've seen a lot of people do like Lidl ones, but Lidl's like a bit out of the way, as I don't drive, like I can't really get there like just walking. So yeah, we chose M&S instead. It actually had a new like donut, so I picked that up and I was like, oh yeah. So I'm very excited to try all these foods. So if you want to watch me rate them and try them, then keep on watching. I think someone's like literally cooking in the kitchen, so mind me if you can hear noises in the background. That is what it is, because I live with other people, so that it is what it is. I don't know where to start. I've got 6 donuts, 2 croffins and 2 pastries, so I feel like I want to start with I feel like we've got a lot of donuts, so I want to do them last. We should start with the pastries and then work our way down. First thing I'm going to try is the pastries, obviously. So I've got a pan of chocolat and I've got a chocolate twist. So this is the pan of choc. So I've got a fair amount, I'd say. Oh my god. I literally don't know how I'm going to rate all of this, like, below a 10. Okay. Pan au chocolat is going at a number. I'm going to give myself 3 ratings. I'm going to give myself a number 10, which means, like, it's really, really good. Like, I would buy again. Like, it's 100% bomb. And then I'm going to do a number 5, which is going to be, like, it's good. It's really good, but wouldn't necessarily eat it again. And then we're gonna have a 0, which is I don't like it and I wouldn't buy it again. Okay, yeah. So the pan au chocolat, is going at number 5, just because it's really good, and like, who doesn't love pan au chocolat? It's really good. It's quite big for what you get, and it looks very fresh. So now I've got this looks massive. Can we just take a moment? Okay, so it looks like this. I just showed you, but still, it looks really yummy. Is it just me, but I literally cannot stand hearing people eat? Like, I just hate it. Like, if you're an ASMR fan, I'm sorry, but I'm not there for it. That is so good. That's really, really good. That's going at a 10, just because, like, it's so, like, filling and it looks really good, like, and it tastes really good. And the difference between the pan au chocolat, which I like, is the gooey bit in the middle, like how there's chocolate and then there's like, what is that, custard? I actually don't know what it is, the like yellowy bit in the middle, like I generally don't know what it's called. So now I'm gonna go in with so I tried to pick up, I mean, I did pick up basically everything that was left, apart from like 1 or 2, only because I've got a lot here, and like the ones I didn't pick up were like the obvious ones, like the chocolate one, the chocolate muffin, and the like lemon one. Like, they're just, everyone knows what they like taste like, so I feel like I didn't need to do a review on them, if you know what I mean. But yeah, so this one is the Victoria Sponge Muffin. I don't really know if muffins are like my type of thing. It looks like that, by the way. But it's a Victoria Sponge one, so let's have a taste. She's kind of thick. I literally don't know how to eat it. Oh my god. There's jam in the middle. She good. Guys, it's literally like, I know it's just a muffin. Like, oh my god, it's just a muffin. But it's literally like a muffin that is a Victoria sponge cake. I'm like here like wanting more. And I shouldn't because I've got so much left. Only cheat day allowed. She's going out of 10. I'm so sorry, guys. But I feel like I'm going to rate everything out of 10 just because everything's really good. And I would definitely like buy everything again. That's going at number 10. Like, you've got the cream on the top and it's just the right amount. And then you get a surprise with the jam in the middle, and then tastes like a Victoria sponge. Like, it's literally a Victoria sponge in a muffin. So we've got this one next. So this is the, I think it's a banana. No, it's a banoffee. If you see it on this one, it's got a sticker on. Hello. But it doesn't have a sticker on this one, so I don't really know what it's called. I think it's like a banoffee with an almond pie, or a banana with an almond pie. It's something like that. But we'll find out when we taste it. This is like a taste testing what it is. Okay, so it looks like this. Yeah, it's banoffee, definitely banoffee. I can smell it. So there's almonds on the top, and then it's just a muffin. So we're gonna try it. I do like banoffee personally, so I think I'll like this, to be honest. Okay. I don't think it's the one. It's very dry. Like, there's nothing really going on inside. I do like it. It is yummy. Because I do like banoffee. And I do like bananas and stuff. So, I don't know. I feel like I wouldn't buy it again necessarily. But if you like bananas and you're like a massive banoffee fan, then I definitely get that. I'm going to rate that at number 5. Just because I wouldn't buy it again. But I definitely do like it. I do like it. But yeah, I feel like there's a lot more going on in the Victoria sponge one. And just, I need a little bit of flavour, like the nuts on top, just it's all a little bit dry. But if you like bread, it's like basically just a banoffee muffin. So you'd like that if you are a bread type of girl. Okay, so next we've got the donuts. Whoop whoop. So I've got 6 donuts sitting in front of me, and they all look very interesting. Very interesting. I think I'm gonna start with the boring to least boring, if that makes sense. I've got one that's new here, so I'm really excited to try that. I'm gonna try this one first. So this is called the milk and cookies yum nut. So I'll open it up. I think she, why do I refer to everything as she? I've never had like cookies in a donut before, I don't think. Is that normal? I don't think I have. So yeah, and I don't think I've seen this at M&S before, so I did want to try it. I don't know if this was supposed to happen. There's literally a bit of biscuit in it, like just on the side, like that's the donut. Oh my god, they're massive. They're so worth the price, like they're so big. How does one even hold it? You guys can't even see. It doesn't even justify it on camera, but it's so big. Okay, we're just gonna jump straight in. I think I will like this one, to be honest. It does just kind of taste like a donut. I mean, I don't know, maybe I'm not like as far in, but it doesn't look like there's anything else going on. That is really good. That's gonna go at number 5. It's good, but like, I know that I would prefer like another one. So yeah, it's just, it's not necessarily bland, but I mean, it's a lot like for milk, cookies and cream, I'd expect like some cookies in it. I don't know. So yeah, she's going to go at number 5. Number 5 today, because I wouldn't buy it again, but it is really good. Next, I've got the double chocolate yum nuts. So I think they're all yum nuts. Yeah, they're all yum nuts. So all their donuts are called yum nuts. So it's a a yum yum in the donut, which is really pang because I love yums. Like, yums are just, like, amazing. Also, oh my god, it was so funny. I was at the self-scan bit. She was like, someone's having a bit of fun tonight. I didn't know what to say to her because I wasn't going to be like, yeah, like, I'm eating all of this. Like, she obviously suspected, like, I was, like, going. So, I don't know. Like, I literally just had donuts and pastries in my basket. Like, I bought, like, basically the whole of the bakery. Like, there was barely any stuff left when I left the store. And, yeah. So, I really wonder what that woman was thinking, to be honest. And then when I left, she was like, yeah, have fun tonight. I'm literally here on my own eating all this stuff and she thinks I'm probably having a massive sesh. Like, no. So this one's really big too. I think they're all gonna be massive because they're yum yums and yum yums are quite thick. I can't believe I didn't even notice they were yum yums. So this one looks like this. This one is called the double chocolate yum nut. I think this will be really nice because I like chocolate, like I said, so I think I'll prefer this one to the other one. Yeah, that's really good. If you're like a chocolate type of person, I definitely recommend that one just because it's got like sprinkles on the top and then it's got chocolate, like a covered chocolate base, and it's just really good. It's really, really good storyline. So I'm gonna rate that one at a number 10, just because I'd definitely buy that one again. That's my type of donut right there. 10 out of 10. But yeah, if you don't like yum yums, then you're literally not gonna like any of these donuts. The next one's called a plain Jane dough yum nut. So this is literally, I think this is just a yum yum shaped as a donut. Can you guys see? All the yum yum is literally in there. Like all the icing, I mean. I'm really loving how like massive they all are. Like, yeah, here we go. That's really good as well. It's literally just a yum yum, like shaped as a donut. Can you see? That one's really good. I'm gonna go at number 5, just because I feel like I would buy that again, but more in like a yum yum form. Just because it's in a donut form, like it's basically a yum yum in a donut, so you'd get more out of buying the yum yums. But that is really good. I would probably buy all of these again, apart from the dry banoffee one. Okay, so we've got 3 things left. I'm really excited, to be honest. So we've got all of these left. This is the new one, so I'm gonna do that one last, and then I'm gonna do this one just because it looks really pretty and really different. So it's a raspberry royal yum yum. I keep saying yum yum. It's a raspberry royal yum nut. So they call all their donuts yum nuts. I feel like we're getting a bit more adventurous now. Like, these are the ones that I would walk into the store and be like, oh yeah, I want to try that. Like, all the ones I've tried so far, I feel like you could get them anywhere, but these I've never really seen before. So this one looks really appealing. This looks very appetizing. Look how pretty it looks. Looks so pretty. So it's just a raspberry donut, I think. I'm not gonna lie to you, I am starting to feel a little bit sick just from eating all this sugar. I don't usually eat as much sugar as I am right now, so yeah, we love this. But yeah, it looks so pretty. I'd just buy that for the looks, to be honest. I don't really like I do like raspberry, but not, I don't really have it like in things, so this will be interesting to see. Okay, that's really nice, but it's a very strong, like it's a lot of raspberry on top. Do you see all the raspberries on top? Like, that's quite powerful. It kind of looks like a little bit like a flower. Yeah, so it is really raspberry. I don't want to rate it a 0 because it's not bad, but I feel like I haven't rated anything a 0. But that is good. Like, it does, I'd say it looks the best out of all of them. So I can't rate it a 0. Like, I'm gonna rate it a 5 just because I wouldn't get it again. Just because it is quite sweet. It's very sweet. I'm more of a like plain Jane type of girl. Next we are gonna try the billionaire's yum nut. I'm excited to try this one because I love like billionaires. I love like that's like could easily say like that's my favorite type of chocolate in a way. She looks really insane. Can you guys see? There's like shortbread on that side and then there's like drizzle on that side. So I'm gonna like eat it in the middle so I get a bit of both. This is so messy. Honestly, don't recommend this video. No, I do, but it's just really, really messy. Cheers, lads. Oh my God. That has to be the best one by far. Yes, Queenies. That's so good. I feel like it's the toffee on top. So they've put like toffee on top underneath the drizzles, you see. Right, and then the other side is just, I think it's toffee. I think they've put toffee all over, to be honest. But I could taste it more on that side. And then they've put shortbread. That's such a good combination. Like, that is so good. I've literally never heard of this before either. Like, I've never heard of half these things, but they've done like such a cool thing with all their donuts, like a billionaire's donut. Who would have thought that? But that's so good. That's going at 10 out of 10, obviously. Would buy again and highly recommend. Like, I'm demolishing that one tonight, 100%. Okay. I'm quite scared for the next one. Just because, like, my brother literally, because I was talking to him about, like, videos and stuff. And he was like, while I was in M&S, he texted me, but I didn't read it until I got home. And then I read it, and I'm pretty sure he said this. He, like, said there's a new one. But I didn't see his text, and then I was like, oh, I got it. But I think he might have been on about something else, but this is new anyway. So this was the only new thing in there, I'm pretty sure. Oh, so it's a hot cross bun yum nut. So it's literally a hot cross bun donut. So they've styled it like a hot cross bun. I'm really, oh my God, it smells like hot cross bun. Yeah, that literally smells like a hot cross bun has just been put in the toaster. I feel like it'll be a bit dry. I feel like it's gonna be a bit like the muffin. So it looks like that. So yeah, let's go. That's very interesting. Save the best till last. That's really good. Like, they've put a layer of hot cross bun mix or whatever the batter mix is for hot cross bun. However the frick they make hot cross buns, I feel like they've put some of the mix on top as a layer. I'll like try and show you. Do you see that? There's like a layer, but it smells of it and it tastes like it. Like, it literally tastes like hot cross bun. And then the rest is yum yum. And then the chocolate chips just blend in nicely. And then the icing literally just tastes like as it would on a hot cross bun. That is so good. Like, I'm glad they brought this out. It tastes so good. I would highly recommend. Like, how do people think of these things? We were actually in M&S and I saw some hot cross buns and they were like chocolate hot cross buns. And I'm like, hot cross buns have got to like a new level. In Tesco's, I kid you not, they do apple and cheese or something like that. I might be completely wrong. When I was in M&S and saw them, I was like, hello, like, when did hot cross buns turn into chocolate hot cross buns? Like, that's like a sweet treat now. Like, hot cross buns to me were always like breakfast in the morning, like, but now like people are having them for like dinner, pudding, like, there's so many flavors and I don't know how people have the minds to think like that. Honestly, I have no idea how they do it. That is going at 10 out of 10, 100%. That is so good. And it literally just tastes like a hot cross bun, entirely like a hot cross bun. Yeah, so that's the end of my video. I would highly recommend all of these foods. But they all taste so, so good. I definitely want to do more videos like this, 100%. Like, I want to do trying the whole pastry at Lidl or Aldi or anything like that. Thank you guys so, so much for watching my video. I would really appreciate a thumbs up on this video. And if you want to subscribe and join my channel, make sure to click the button down below. I'm active on my socials pretty much all the time if you ever wanted to message me or let me know about how I'm doing or anything. Also shout out to my Depop, I'm selling loads of stuff on that. I've literally got a whole pile of bits over here that are just waiting for me to put up. I'm so busy at the moment, so I'm just trying to organize everything out, but the minute I've got a chance to, I'm gonna put more stuff up. I put loads of stuff up the other week, probably like 2 weeks ago, I don't know. So yeah, links will be in the description. I usually send them off the next day, or 2 days, like it's pretty quick delivery. So yeah, I'll put my Depop on the screen somewhere now and link will be in the description. Literally just message me on it before you buy anything and I will reply to you straight away. Most likely, I'm active quite a lot on it. Yeah, my socials will be linked in the description. But yeah, I'm gonna try and upload once a week. If you guys can comment on any of my socials what day you'd prefer, I might do like a poll on Instagram or something, but I feel like I wanted to do a Sunday because Sundays are my least busiest days, and that's when I don't do like gym and stuff. So I feel like I do want to do on a Sunday, but I'd rather your guys' opinions and stuff. So I will put a poll out for that. But I do want to start uploading once a week, consistently once a week, and yeah, so there's a lot more to come from me. So hopefully I'll be seeing you guys next week with a brand new video. And yeah, thanks to you guys so much for watching this video. I appreciate and love every single one of you. And yeah, I really enjoyed filming this video, so thank you for watching and I love you all so much, and yeah, bye.